gives this woman in marriage? Let's pray. Most gracious God, we give you thanks for your tender love in sending Jesus Christ to come among us, to be born of a human mother, and to make the way of the cross to be the way of life. We thank you also for consecrating the union of man and woman in his name. By the power of your Holy Spirit, pour out the abundance of your blessings upon Bobby and Kristin. And Lord, we ask that you would look mercifully upon them as they come to you seeking your blessing. Assist them, we pray, with your grace, that with true fidelity and steadfast love, they may honor and keep the promises and vows they make today. Defend them from every enemy. Lead them into all peace. Let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts, a mantle about their shoulders, and a crown upon their foreheads. Bless them in their work and in their companionship, in their sleeping and in their waking, in their joys and in their sorrows, in their life and in their death. In your mercy, bring them to your heavenly banquet where your saints feast forever at the great marriage supper of the Lamb. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. Family and friends, we have gathered together today in the presence of God to witness and bless the joining together of Robert O'Neill and Kristin Visk in marriage. That's not going to be your name anymore in a few minutes. Almighty God established the bond and covenant of marriage in creation and proclaimed it to be a sign of the mystical union between Christ and his church. Additionally, our Lord Jesus Christ blessed this manner of life with his presence and first miracle when he attended a wedding in Cana of Galilee. And finally, it is commended by Holy Scripture to be held in honor among all people. Today is the culmination of a lot of yeses. Bobby said yes in his desire to marry Kristin. My dad said yes to letting Bobby marry Kristin. Kristin said yes to Bobby's proposal. And to paraphrase Dietrich Bonhoeffer, today God will add his yes to your yes. Because through the vows and commitments pronounced here today, God creates something beautiful and sacred out of your love, holy matrimony. In short, God is pleased that you are standing here today to join in this wonderful gift of marriage. And to that end, we too join to celebrate, witness, and heartily endorse our support for you two as you enter this new chapter of your lives. Marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes for which it was ordained by Almighty God. In this holy union, Bobby and Kristin now come to be joined. Bobby and Kristin, today you are doing more than simply saying, I do. You are presenting yourselves before your family and friends, and most importantly, before God, to declare your intention of uniting your lives together for the service of God and neighbor. You are making a dedication to each other in a lasting and indivisible union that shall endure for the remaining years of your lives. But it is God who makes your marriage indissoluble. In Matthew chapter 19, Jesus commands, "What therefore God has joined together, let not man separate." It is God who joins you together in marriage, not your vows, not your will, not even your love for one another. And therefore, it is God who protects it. Know then that there is no power on earth, nor any human weakness that can dissolve what God holds together. With this knowledge, you can, in full assurance, pledge your love to one another for the remainder of your days. Therefore, in the presence of your family and friends as witnesses, I charge you, therefore, first of all, to consider that your promises to each other are made in the presence of a God who remembers all things and who will hold you responsible for performing them. Your vows must be kept unbroken before him. And when either one of you fails, which you will, you must meet that failure with grace and repentance, looking always together at the one who has and always will keep his promises to you. I admonish you to keep in mind that your marriage is a reflection of Christ and the church. As such, your marriage should be marked with sacrificial giving, mutual uplifting, and abundant love. Always remember you are but a temporary placeholder in each other's lives until the day when the true and ultimate reality of marriage is revealed at the marriage supper of the Lamb. I encourage you to share willingly and hear sympathetically your joys and worries, your successes and your struggles, and to be neither conceited by the former nor depressed by the latter. Whichever may prevail, cling closely to each other, that defeat may be met by united strength and victories by united joy. I charge you to make your home a place where you both can find refuge from the storms of life, but not only for yourselves, but also for your neighbors. Let your home be a haven for the weary, a source of uplift for the discouraged, and a convincing testimony and living witness to a watching world. In short, recognize the Lord Jesus Christ as the head of your house, the ruler of your destinies, and the object of your deepest affection. If you do, he will confirm your marriage by his guidance and will overshadow it by his peace. So I've had the privilege of knowing Bobby and Kristin for a long time now. I first met Kristin about 28 years ago on September 29th, although I don't really remember much from that night. I'm not sure why that is. Memories of Kristin include her bribing me with money to massage her back, her spraying Windex in my food accidentally because she would start cleaning up before I was done, and her providing a shoulder to cry on when I had my first breakup. Kristin and I have always had a very close relationship. I always thought it was because I was sort of the black sheep in the family, you know, the one that FedEx dropped off at the footstool of the house. But Kristin never made me feel that way. Kristin has always made me feel included and important. She has always made me feel taken care of and loved. Bobby, on the other hand, well, I haven't known him for quite so long. We first met last year during an online game of Monopoly. During the height of lockdown in London, I kind of got really into board games, so much that I found a way to play online with people around the world. My first interaction with Bobby was in one of these games where he clearly cheated and somehow won. It wasn't a very good first impression, if I must say. But of course, I immediately backed down on the cheating taunts when I first met him in person because I realized he was a heck of a lot taller and a lot more in shape than I was. Memories of Bobby include stalking him on social media, imitating his stretches for pictures, even though I don't have an ounce of athleticism in me, and seeing the way my sister melted whenever he spoke. Kristin first met Bobby when I was living abroad, and as a younger brother, I'm not typically associated with being the protective older brother. But after years of watching my sister's love life and the pain and hurt she's gone through, I have naturally grown to be very protective of her. When I first heard about you, Bobby, I had my suspicions, because I couldn't bear to see Kristin's heart broken again. But as time passed, and I heard from many different people about the way he treated her, the way he loved her, and the way he challenged her to grow in her faith and as a person, I came to respect you, Bobby, before I even got to meet you in person. Bobby, Kristin is a very special person, especially to me. I've always shared a special relationship with her, and she has taken care of me in a way that I can never repay. Kristin was very motherly to me, always going the extra mile to make sure I had everything I needed. She would come to all my band concerts. She would make me tea when I was sick. And she even let me do all of the physical labor when we went kayaking in San Diego.
You're not alone.
All in all, Kristin is one of the most selfless people I have ever known. And she will love you fiercely and loyally for the rest of her life. Kristin, Bobby is a very special person. Bobby's the only person I know who has managed to get you to leave the house past 6:30 p.m.
That's true.
He also is the most famous TikTok star I know. But more than that, Bobby has challenged you to grow as a person. He does not let you sweep anything under the rug, something our family is quite good at. He invites you to share your feelings and frustrations with him. And his openness with you has allowed you to open up as a person to become more honest and real. Bobby is also kind and gentle, and has deep convictions about his beliefs. Through our hangouts together, I've come to see that Bobby is truly the only person I know who who deserves to love you and be loved by you. So cherish him. Our God is a God of patterns. He deals in symmetry, and the Bible is full of it. In fact, the Bible both begins and ends with the story of marriage. And from these marriages, we learn a valuable lesson about ours as well. When God saw that it was not good for Adam to be alone, he sought to find a suitable companion for him. When nothing that he had yet created was a match for Adam, the Lord caused a deep sleep to fall upon him and took one of his ribs. From that rib, God designed and fashioned a wife perfect for him. Meeting at the combine kitchen is a lot easier than that, isn't it? But in the first marriage, it was only after Adam had literally been torn apart did he receive the glorious bride which God had perfectly designed for him. Similarly, at the end of creation history, we read in Revelation about the last Adam, Jesus, who has presented his glorious bride. Just like the first Adam, Jesus fell into a deep sleep, the deep sleep of death. He was torn apart when he was beaten and hung on a cross. And it was precisely because of this that he received a bride perfect for him from the Father. Eve was fashioned from the rib in Adam's side, and the church was fashioned from the blood and water that flowed from Jesus' side. Leading up to performing this ceremony, I had the chance to hear more about Bobby and Kristen's story. I've learned about their past and the heartaches that they both have gone through. Both of them have in one time or another been heartbroken, hurt, and left in pieces. And I couldn't help but think about how this story reflects the cosmic story of marriage given in the Bible. In this brokenness, God found them and healed them. And now he has given them to each other. Through these experiences, Bobby and Kristen have been torn apart, but here today, they stand at the altar to be united together. United in love, united in marriage, and united in Jesus. Your marriage is a picture of the hope you have in a God who makes all things beautiful in his time. But it doesn't end there. In the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 16, Jesus tells his disciples, "If anyone would come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me." And we see that from Genesis to Revelation, Adam to last Adam, the way of marriage has been the way of the cross. Kristen and Bobby, your marriage is no different. It may seem paradoxical, but it's true. If you want a marriage filled with happiness and joy, if you want your marriage to glorify God, and if you want your marriage to be successful, then you will have to travel the path of the cross. Because the way of death is the way of life, and the way up is the way down. In Philippians 2, Paul reminds us that Jesus humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death in order to receive the name above every name. This too seems contradictory. Why would the Son of God humble himself in order to be glorified? Paul teaches us that Jesus took the form of a servant and humbled himself precisely because he existed in the form of God. The cross, therefore, is the full expression of who he is. And it is because of this that we are called to the way of the cross, because it is the way of God himself. We are followers of Jesus when we follow Jesus. Through every trial, every joy, every letdown, and every celebration, carry your cross together and encourage each other to look to the perfecter of your faith. This is the hope of every Christian marriage, including yours. Not that your marriage will be free of fighting or of trouble. Kristen, Bobby won't always use Lysol when he's done using the bathroom or clean like mom does. Bobby, Kristen won't look like this tomorrow morning when she wakes up. But all of those troubles and challenges will one day be transformed into glory by the transforming power of the cross of Jesus. This is the hope of your marriage, that your marriage will manifest the glory of the triune God, the glory of humility. And this is the hope of your marriage, that the way of the cross is not only the way to glory, but the way of glory. Bobby and Kristen will now exchange their vows. Bobby, if you will, please take Kristen's hand and repeat after me. In the name of God.
In the name of God.
I, Bobby.
Take you, Kristen.
To be my wife. To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
According to God's holy word. This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Now, Kristin, if you'll please repeat after me. In the name of God.
In the name of God.
I, Kristin.
Take you, Bobby.
To be my husband. To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse. For richer, for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Until we are parted by death. According to God's holy word. This is my solemn vow. Okay. And now, Bobby, I have a question for you. Do you take this woman to be your wife, to live together out of reverence for Christ and the covenant of holy matrimony? Do you vow to love her, honor her, comfort and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Kristin, do you take this man to be your husband, to live together out of reverence for Christ in the covenant of holy matrimony? Do you vow to honor him, love him, comfort and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Bobby and Kristin will now exchange rings as a symbol of their love and commitments to each other. We can have the rings, please. Bobby, you first gave a ring to Kristin to represent your love for her. But now, as you exchange rings here, you are reminded that while your love may come from you, marriage comes from God. And as Dietrich Bonhoeffer once again said, it is not your love that sustains the marriage, but from now on, the marriage that sustains your love. Let these rings forever be a reminder of that. Bobby, please take the ring and place it on Kristin's left hand and repeat after me. Kristin,
I give you this ring
as a token and pledge
of my constant faith
and abiding love.
Okay.
Kristin, please place the ring on Bobby's left hand and repeat after me. Bobby,
I give you this ring
as a token and pledge
of my constant faith.
And abiding love.
Okay.
Bobby and Kristin have chosen to partake of the Lord's Supper. Please take this moment to pray individually for them and for their marriage. How do you feel?
Oh my God, I'm gonna trip.
Take a breath. Moment. Collect yourselves. Okay. Let me pray. Distribute the elements and I'll give you some time to be together, okay? Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love you made us for yourself. And when we had sinned against you and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent your only Son, Jesus Christ, into the world for our salvation. By the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, he became flesh and dwelt among us. In obedience to your will, he stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself once for all, that by his suffering and death we might be saved. By his resurrection, he broke the bonds of death, trampling hell and Satan under his feet. As our great high priest, he ascended to your right hand in glory, that we may come with confidence before your throne of grace. Amen. On the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." You can go ahead and take it. Likewise, after supper, Jesus took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this in remembrance of me."
Took a really big piece.
I saw.
Yeah, too big.
You need a lot of Jesus. Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ has risen. Christ will come again. Amen. Take this time together to pray. Have a moment. About 2 seconds, you guys are gonna be married, okay? All right, I'll follow after you. Insomuch as Bobby and Kristin have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God and those gathered here today and have pledged their faith to each other and have declared the same by the giving and receiving of rings, then by the power vested in me as a minister of the gospel, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Bobby, you may kiss your bride. Whoa. All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is my distinct privilege to present to you for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Robert Logan O'Neill.
on a flat bottom metal boat. Coke cans and BB guns, barbed wire and old fence posts. 8-point bucks in autumn and freshly cut cornfields. One arm out the window and one hand on the wheel. Some things just go better together and probably always will. Cup of coffee and a sunrise. Sunday drives and time to kill. What's the point of this old guitar if it ain't got no strings? Or pouring your heart into a song that you ain't gonna sing. It's a match made up in heaven, like good old boys and beer and me, as long as you're right here. Your license in my wallet when we go out downtown. Your lipstick stained every coffee cup that I got in this house. The way you say I love you too is like rain on an old tin roof. And your hand fits right into mine like a needle in a groove. Some things just go better together and probably always will. Like a cup of coffee and a sunrise. Sunday drives and time to kill. What's the point of this old guitar if it ain't got no strings? Or pouring your heart into a song that you ain't gonna sing. It's a match made up in heaven, like good old boys and beer. As long as you're right here. Sometimes we're oil and water, but I wouldn't have it any other way. And if I'm being honest, your first and my last name would just sound better together. And probably always will. Like a cup of coffee and a sunrise. Sunday drives and time to kill. What's the point of this old guitar if it ain't got no strings? Or pouring your heart into a song that you ain't gonna sing. It's a match made up in heaven, like good old boys and beer. And me, as long as you're right here. And me, as long as you're right here.
Be time for the father-daughter dance.
Don't cry.
Andrew or Bobby?
May these words be the first to find you. Is brighter than the sun now that you're here. Though your eyes will need some time to adjust to the overwhelming light surrounding us. Teach you everything I know. I promise I'll do better. I'll always hold you close, but I'll learn to let you go.
mother and groom dance.
The angels protect you, trouble neglect you, and heaven accept you. When it's time to go home, may you always have plenty, your glass never empty, and know in your belly you're never alone. May your tears come from laughing, you find friends worth having. With every year passing, they mean more than gold. May you win, but stay humble, smile more than grumble, and know when you stumble, you're never
bit of a surprise if Lynn Visk can head out to the dance floor.
Uh-oh.
We're going to have a mother and daughter dance.
Are you kidding
me? Really? Mother,
emotional.
Giving me away,
yeah,
is my goodbye.
I wasn't supposed to have a switch. But Bobby and I met about 7 years ago. I met him when I was training at the facility that he worked at. And then about 2 years? Mm-hmm. About a 2 year gap. And then we were kind of brought together through unhighlighted circumstance later in life. And I had just moved out here from North Carolina. And my dad had recommended me getting or living with a roommate. So through different circumstances, it presented an opportunity to live with Bobby. And what I thought, I was just getting, you know, half the rent cut off, turned into, within about 2 months, you were at my brother's bachelor party, invited to his wedding at the same day, and then pretty much became a family member right after that. He met Kristin, here we go, a year or half a year after that?
Four months after that.
And then the day he came home, it was supposed to be just met somebody from church, but it was a different tone of voice when he told her story. And I was kind of skeptical. We both had a heartbreak recently, so very formative when I met her. But soon after that, both the smiles and the charisma they shared, I knew it was a little different. And as Kristin learned very quickly, I'm super serious, never sarcastic or anything like that. So she had to adjust to that. But like he did, my family, he became a part of theirs, and now we get to make it official.
Thank you so much for coming. Stu and Pam, if you guys are up there, thank you so much. Can we give a hand to Stu and Pam? I love, they gave me a real good price on this backyard venue. It didn't cost me anything. Anyways, if you guys don't know me, my name is Steve, of course, Kristen's dad. If you guys would just take this moment to pray with me just real quickly. Father God, we come before you, Lord. Lord, thank you so much, Father, for this weather that I have prayed for, Lord, since Bobby asked me to marry Kristin, and I found out they were getting married in the mountains up here, Lord. We were just praying for good weather, and thank you. You went above and beyond, Lord. And just thank you so much for bringing Bobby. We were praying for a godly man, and you brought him, Lord. So thank you. All praise and glory to you, Lord. It's in your son's name we pray. Amen. Mr. O'Neill, Roberto, Roberts. You've been an answered prayer, and you have hit the Mega Million lottery like Trevor, John, and Newman. You've hit the Mega Million lottery tonight. I'm just letting you know. I want to welcome you into our family. Kristin, Mom and I are so very happy for you. I know you will make a loving, caring, serving wife. You've waited so patiently for this day and for this man. For those of you who don't know Kristin, I mean really, really know her, she has, like Matthew was sharing when he was marrying him, she has a servant's heart. I know for a fact that she has helped out people in need financially. And Kristin doesn't have a lot of money. I'm not chopping you low, but when she would help somebody, she would give whatever she could. And that's just the way she is. Emotionally, Matthew had shared that as well. If she saw somebody hurting, she would try to encourage them and help them and just give them words of encouragement and listen. She just listened really good to them. Emergency babysitting job for Peyton. Kristin is always there without any hesitation. Kristin, any of the kids, Scarlett, Haddon, all our grandbabies.
Maverick.
Tilly. Yeah. Anyways, any situation, even help clean someone's house. So she would be there in a heartbeat. She's taken really good care of me. Some examples, she would have all my vitamins laid out every morning for me. She'd have my, yes, I drink some kind of health drink. I don't know what it is, but she gave it to me. But she would have it every morning. I would come downstairs and she would have this stuff on the counter. And that, she just took care of me. She made my lunch. Not that Lynn would never do it. Kristin just beat her to it all the time. So I thank you for all them, the stuff you did for me. Then she met Bobby, and that's okay. And I know that she will take good care of you, Bobby. Like my other daughters, this will hit me hard when I pass her room. And she's not there. Even that dumb dog Tucker is sad. This is one of the hardest things to do as a father, is to give one, your daughters away. And she's the last one. So I hope I live long enough to see my granddaughters get married. May the good Lord watch over you in this next chapter of your life.
The floor is open to anyone else who might want to say anything. Chris and Bobby have opened it up to anyone who might want to say anything.
Otherwise, dance.
Otherwise, we're dancing. No one? Anybody else?
Anybody?
Christian.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Hey, guys. Congrats. I guess I don't, it's nothing crazy I have to say, but Tilly wants to tell you lots of things. I just read recently in a book that part, like one of the most important things in the Christian life that you learn is how to wait. You know, I just thought it's like a virtue or whatever, but when I really thought about it, I'm like, oh yeah, that's right. The whole point, one of the points of being Christian is waiting for Jesus to return, and that's what we put our hope in. And so I just hope you guys can remember your entire journey leading up to this point, all the waiting you did with the heartache and time and effort, and all the waiting you did with the happy memories it leading up to this beautiful day. May that be a reminder of the hope that you have in Jesus and the waiting until he returns so we can be together with him. Hmm. And that's it.
Thank you.
You want to dance?
Yeah, dance when the music starts.
Ready, Slate? Ready?